Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you dependent picklist. So controlling picklist will be a single selection picklist and dependent picklist will be multi-selection picklist. So before starting, let me share you how you can get me on YouTube. You can search my name and you can follow Salesforce related videos on my channel. So here I am searching the custom objects. So I have one already created object that is student. So on student, you can see two picklist. First one is course. You can see its data type is picklist. So it is a single selection picklist. And then I have another picklist as multi-select. So for this subject picklist, you can select multiple options. So now I'm going to create course as controlling picklist and subject as the dependent picklist. So I'm clicking on the course. So it is opening the course picklist detail page. Here you can see field dependencies. So I'm clicking on new. So controlling field will be course and I want to make subject as the dependent field. Now I'm clicking on continue. So here you can see course has four values, BTech, BBA, BSc, MBA, and subject picklist values are available under each course picklist value. So now we need to figure out like for course BTech, which subject values we want to populate, for BBA, which values we want to display. So first I'm selecting for BTech picklist value. And that is for course. So I want computer, English, IT, maths. So if I select BTech as picklist value for course field, then subject will be showing computer, English, IT and maths only, right? Now for BBA, I'm selecting computer, economics, English, accounts and finance, right? So these values are selected for BBA. Then for BSc, computer, English, maths and science. And for MBA, economics, accounts, finance, right? So this way I selected the values. So I think network is not selected anywhere. So I am putting it in BTech. So this way all values are somewhere selected, either in BTech or BBA or BSc or MBA. Now I'm going to click on save. Right, so we created this subject as dependent picklist and course as the controlling picklist. Now I'm going to open this student tab. And if I click on new to create a new record for student. So here you will see by default, this subject picklist is not showing any value because it is dependent on course. So once we select any course value, then subject value will be available. So I'm selecting BTech. So here you can see only five values are displayed here: computer, English, IT, maths, and networks. So we can check it again. I'm clicking on edit. So here you can see for BTech, we selected computer, English, IT, maths, and networks. So all these five values are available here. If I select BBA, so values are changed. It is showing computer, economics, English, account, and finance. So for BBA, we selected these five values, right? Now for MBA, we selected economics, account and finance. So if I select MBA, so here you can see it is showing only three values. And as the behavior of multi-select picklist, we can select multiple values. So if I put these values in the chosen part and if I click on save, so these two values will be available for this record. So this way you can make a single selection picklist as controlling and multi-select picklist as dependent picklist, right? Now remember that reverse is not possible. You cannot make multi-select pick list as controlling. So if you try to do so, so there will be a problem, because in case of multi-select pick list, we can choose multiple values at same time. So if you select multiple values at same time and you want it as controlling field, so that will make a problem, like dependent pick list will not be getting proper results, because for controlling multi-select pick list, you selected two values. So this scenario doesn't work. So if you want to see how we can do controlling and dependency, so you can focus on this thing. So here you can see it is saying the field that drives filtering is called the controlling field. Standard and custom checkboxes and pick lists with at least one and less than 300 values can be controlling fields. So here you can see standard and custom checkboxes and only pick lists, not multi-select pick lists. Then second point says the field that has its values filtered is called the dependent fields. So custom pick list. So here it is talking about single selection pick list and multi-select pick list can be dependent fields, right? So on controlling side, we can have only checkboxes and single selection pick list. And on dependent side, we can have a single selection pick list as well as multi-selection pick list. And also notice that on dependent side, we can use only custom pick list, but on the controlling side, we can use standard as well as custom pick list. So I think this is all about controlling and dependent thing for pick list. I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. If you want to follow more Salesforce related videos, then you can open my channel on YouTube by searching my name. Thank you for watching this video.